The ice is typically around 5 centimeters when I skate on it. That sound you hear is actually a combination of two sounds. It's the sounds from cracks striking beneath me and the vibrations within the ice plate itself. It sounds like it's something supersonic.
Meet Märten Ajne.
Hi, I'm Märten Ajne.
He's a mathematician who enjoys riskier hobbies than most.
I've been skating on thin ice for 40 years.
When he's skating, though, he's also listening.
The thinner the ice, the higher the pitch. Just about when the ice is to break, and that would be about 3 centimeters, the pitch is at the high C, the supposedly highest note of the soprano singer.
Märten relies on his knowledge as a mathematician to calculate the thickness of the ice, its flexibility, and its temperature.
Many people tend to freak out when they see us skating on thin ice, but I couldn't be more calm because I know what I'm doing. Sometimes the ice is perfectly clear and I can see fish below, even a beaver, and also free divers swimming under the ice.
When Märten first started, there wasn't any physics or scientific information to explain how thin ice skating is possible. He studied the ice for 10 years every winter to explain the phenomenon.
I observed 3 things with a thin ice. One is that the ice bends, and the thinner it is, the more it bends. The ice needs to be flexible to support you. Second, the first crack is a true warning signal. Then I know the ice is thin. And when it gets even thinner, more cracks evolve. And finally, the ice gives sonorous tone, beautiful, eerie tone, which immediately tells me how thick the ice is. It's called the coincidence frequency, and it can be calculated mathematically.
Märten has skated on over 1,800 bodies of water in North America, Norway, and Central and Eastern Europe.
I love skating for the excitement and challenges it brings. It's an opportunity for math and nature to come together and make it understandable for me. I've been skating most of my life, and I always look forward to next winter.